again. The sprinter plays me, trying me through. Still trying to go through the centre. This is a chance! And a fantastic save inside. Paul Madden putting off a stunning save. Getting that ball up, looking around here and drilling a ball right through to the centre. Again, striking ball. Jack Hannon sent it in and he sends it over the bar. Sends the ball back to the far side of the field. Jack Hannon from way out the field. It's high, it's dropping in and it's dropping straight over the bar. So Tommy Redden in pursuit. David Conroy still holding on to it. He's looking for support. He can't see any. He strikes the ball in. That's a pass score. By the time Tommy Redden strikes this one, let's see what's going to happen. He does that, drills the ball in, and once again, the ball goes in and goes over the bar. Spit O'Briens are back on the score. It is Cathal Rowan with this one. High ball from way out the field. It's high, it's in, and it's straight over the bar once again. 4 points to one. St. Joseph's lead here to the field. And Marco Holland was striking the ball from way out the field. And it comes off the stick of Phil Kelleher over the bar. 5 points to one.
Got the ball to the man in the best position. Ball into the forward line. Paul Cathal over the bar.
To get over the bar is exactly what he has done. He decides to go direct in, looking aside, finding a brilliant ball into Cathal Rowan. He gets room to strike, he sends it in, and he sends it over the bar. 7-1 it is, 17 and a half minutes, and Tommy drills this one in and sends it over the bar from the stick of Tommy Redden. 7 points to two into his hand, being challenged. Now he gets it into his hand. Now will he get room to strike it? He's turning on the 20 metre line. He's surrounded, but he does, and he gets the ball in and gets it over the bar. David O'Shea had a lot of work to do when he got that ball. Brian Gilfoy looking around here, gets it back out to this side of the field, out to Conor Tierney. A shot, the ball blocked here. And will they say a cash ball, a wild ball? They do, but that's exactly what it is.
Himself and his brother Mikey there, and they come from rugby stock, so I wouldn't be inclined to be bouncing off them too often now.
I'm bouncing off and being the operative board is Tommy Redden since the 65, straight over the bat.
Smith O'Brien's there, he didn't score that great. Same man is breaking through now for a shot.
And Cathal Rowan takes the shot, the ball goes in and it goes over the bar. They're trying to get onto that ball, still there to be won on the far side of the field, waiting for his Patrick O'Hearn. Now it comes back to David O'Shea and he snaps the ball straight over the bar. The early moments of this second half, Tommy strikes this one in low and sends the ball over the crossbar. Once again, 8 points to six of this here. It over his shoulder, out it goes to Tom Hannon. He has a chance for this score. That's a good power score. St. Joseph's door of Airfield. Tom Hannon to finish it. 6.5 minutes gone. Let's see what happens.
They have Keith Stritch put in on the full forward on the edge of the square, and they pump a lot of ball direct into him. In fairness, it's paying
to defend. Gets it across to the far side of the field, out to Fionn Keller has the opportunity, lands the ball in, and lands the ball straight over the bar. Once again, St. Joseph's door of Airfield running at the Spit O'Brien's defence. O'Keefe Oil, your number one supplier of heating oil in the County of Clare, is Tommy Redden, number one at the moment. He sends it in and he sends it over the bar. A difficult free at the best of times. Alan O'Neill is in there. He goes to the ground, challenge by Michael Goff against switching play. It's a brilliant ball across to the far side. Once again, sending the ball into the middle of the field is Donal Holland. He's challenged. Ball goes to the ground, still trying to win it down there. Still trying to get Tom Hannon. Tom Hannon is in there. He goes in. He comes out with the ball, but he's whipped out of his hands once again. Fionn Keller has on it, takes the shoulder, just gets away in time, goes to the ground here and wins the free. And I think if ever I saw a player winning a free, that is right up there with one of the best on Fionn Keller. He knew he was going over, he dived in, won. It still remains St. Joseph's Tour of Airfield leading by two with 11 minutes gone. Puck out as fast as out to David Conroy, out to this side of the field, puts the ball on the stick, up along the line, about to be challenged, releases the ball into the centre, trying to get onto that ball on the far side of the field, and running onto was Bossy Herr. He comes into the centre, runs into traffic. Also winning the ball is Eddie Bork. He runs into St. Joseph's door of Airfield, foul, and it's going to be a free and an opportunity from just outside his own 65 metre line for Tommy Redden. He's down in his knees at the moment. He'd been inside his own half of the field, about to strike this one. It's high, it's looking good from here. The ball goes in and it goes over the bar. An excellent score for Tommy Redden and for Smith O'Brien's on the far side. Also trying to win the ball and coming over, it's drilling the ball into the centre. In it goes to the middle of the field and the ball just going behind Marco Holland. Alan O'Neill wins it out to Brian Gilfoyle. Brian Gilfoyle to David Conroy. David Conroy taking on the defence, chased out there by Eddie Bourke, releases the ball into the edge of the square, trying to win the ball. Keane Nolan comes out, puts his hand in the hurley, comes out and challenges, goes back, sends it back to the far side to Mark Stretch. Mark Stretch inches on his knees, gets it out to David Goff, and David Goff with a pine barber right into the edge of the square. Paul Metten is under it, and it just comes off his hand and goes out for a 65 metre line. Absolutely players down here to our left hand side and the intermediate hole. It's hard to tell me, Redden, about to strike this one. Huge moment for Smith O'Brien's, and he sends it over the bar. The sides are level at QZ Park.
They've, you know, they've been reliant on Carl Owen and the Hennings and the gut and Fionn Kelly from the halfback line.
And Carl Owen sends the ball straight over the bar from the 320-metre line. He takes David Conroy just off the shoulder, runs onto this ball. He has the chance to pop it over the bar. Will he do that? He sends the ball in, and he sends it over the bar. Running at the defence all day long, they were. Is looking at the post down here to our right hand side, drills this one in, and the umpire comes out. He raises the white flag as Tommy Redden and Smith O'Brien's have put the deficit to a single point.
You know, ultimately turned over and resulted in the free.
And the free is gone straight over the bar from the stick of Tommy Redden. It's deadlocked at 12 points apiece here in the park. Which way you look at it, this is the opportunity for Smith O'Brien's. It's high, it's dropping in, and it's dropping over the bar. Tommy Redden has put Smith O'Brien into the lead. Smith O'Brien's winning it out to Michael Goff. Michael Goff got through. He wins the free. Gets straight in front of the goal on the 20-metre line. And Smith O'Brien are jumping around the pass down on the sideline.
All day and all year, they managed to turn them over again, and again it's resulted in a free.
And it's Tommy Redden sending the ball. It's landing out around Tuller somewhere as he sends the ball over the bar. Niall Malone is on the far side of the field. The referee blows the final whistle. And Smith O'Brien have won the Intermediate Hurling Championship. One of the sides predicted throughout the year here. They've won it in fantastic fashion. St. Joseph's Dorabare Field through everything that they possibly could. It's unreal down their path, and it's a moment they will never forget.
Absolutely. I mean, I think you're seeing the pain of five semi-final defeats coming out there, but you'd have to say worthy winners. As I said, you can have no qualms. I mean, they're more polished outfit all year and really, really dug it out. And as I said, worthy winners.
Absolutely.
They have more than enough to stay afloat and to prosper at that level.
Absolutely. The spirit alone will get him a long, long way. Right down here, the noise you can hear is coming from on the field and off the field for the Smith O'Brien supporters as they come right down here into the stand under us. Champions at Intermediate, they've played so many Intermediate games over a long, long number of years, finally making the breakthrough. It's like champagne that's jumping up in the air here. It's bottles of water that's in there. They're right down on the sideline, right in front of their supporters, and you can imagine the cheer that's going to come up out here in just a few moments, as you can hear in the background. As I said, as we wind up here, thanks to Pat O'Keefe, to Pat Flynn back at base, and of course once again to Derek on production this afternoon, and to Pat O'Connor. Pat, thanks a million. Delighted you could join us, the most appropriate person, as I said.
Last two games there against Tubber and Tulla really kind of paid dividends there now today. You have to beat the best to be the best, don't you? And we had our first two games, we were coming with fast side winners. And kind of the last group game against Tulla, I think, really crowned them. It was a battle pint for pint, and we kind of won it in the last, only literally that football ball, we got late goal and won it.
Tony, I think they're looking for you there behind. Congratulations today, and best of luck in the Munster Championship.